Fourier series. In Fourier series, we are discussing about functions having arbitrary periods. So consider a function g of x and which is of period 2L. Note that it is not 2π. So in 2π case, we know how to find out the Fourier series. But here, the period is not 2π, it is 2L. In that case, a simple adjustment in the scale, we can find it as g of x is equal to or is approximately equal to a naught plus sigma n equal to 1 to infinity. So I should write it is equal to or approximately equal to a naught plus sigma n equal to 1 to infinity a n cos n pi by l into x plus b n sin n pi by l into x. Note that in the usual case we are writing cos a n cos nx. Instead of that, here coming pi by l term. Here also pi by l term is coming. Then the Fourier coefficients are given by a naught is equal to 1 by 2 l into integral minus l to l g of x dx and a n as 1 by l into integral minus l to l g of x cos n pi by l into x dx and bn as 1 by l integral minus l to l g of x into sin n pi by l into x dx for n is equal to 1, 2, 3 extra. Next is to find the Fourier expansion of a function is given. F of x as given as 0 if x is lying in the interval minus 2 to 0 and 1 if x is lying in the interval 0 to 2. So let us see how it can be solved. So solution part, first of all we have written whatever the function is given and next thing we are finding a naught. So a naught 1 by 2 l into integral minus l to l f of x dx. Doing integration you will get one part is 0 because minus 2 to 0 is value 0. Next one is integral 0 to 2 1 dx and we got that at as 1 by 2. Similarly an can be found out by 1 by l integral minus l to l f of x into cos n pi by l into x dx. Again using the formula integral of, you know that integral of cos nx is sin nx by 2 into x into the 1 by derivative of n pi by 2 into x, that is we can write it as it is in the reciprocal form, so 2 by n pi. So at last we are getting that as 1 by n pi into 0. The 0 we got by, if we are substituting the upper limit in this, we will get sin n pi 2 by 2 1. So we are getting n sin n pi, that value is 0. Again if you are substituting the value 0, sin 0 will result 0. So this term is 0. Similarly we can find the bn term. Bn term using the formula minus l to l f of x into sin n pi by l into x dx and this is got by 1 by 2, the same thing. We are going for the integration and at last we are getting as minus 1 by n into cos n pi minus cos 0. So again minus 1 by n pi into minus 1 power n minus 1 1 by n pi into 1 minus minus 1 power n. Now substituting these all values for a naught, an, and bn in this expression, we will get the sequence as, or the sorry, the series as 1 by 2 plus sigma n equal to 1 to infinity 1 minus minus 1 power n by n pi into sin n pi by 2 into x. Further, if we want this, we can go for it expansion. So we get 1 by 2 into 2 by pi sin pi x by 2 plus 2 by 3 pi sin 3 pi by 2 into x plus x.